How are we doing, folks? Your host Moose here on the Pitt Panthers Football Network as we welcome you to Orlando, Florida for the Russell Athletic Bowl, where your Pitt Panthers are set to take on the Georgia Bulldogs. It's a great matchup for the Panthers, a prestigious opponent, one that Pitt has not taken on since the early 1980s, and the Panthers have a great track record against. It's going to be Georgia, a very notable team. They've got some very talented players. Carter Ford, one of the best young quarterbacks in the country. Travis Morris, arguably the top receiver talent-wise in the entire nation. So a lot of weapons for this Georgia offense to use against the Pitt Panthers pass defense. But we'll see how things shake out. It's going to be a great matchup, and we're set to get you underway here from Orlando, Florida. The Panthers set to receive Davion Reynolds back, and we are underway here with the Russell Athletic Bowl. The last showing of the Russell Athletic Bowl that we will see. It is slated to become the Cheez-It Bowl for next season, alongside many, many changes set to occur in the bowl lineup with the inclusion of college football revamped. So Davion Reynolds, the man to take the handoff on the first play for the Panthers, goes up the middle for 7 yards, and we can see that it's going to be the 21st-ranked Pitt offense against the 27th-ranked Georgia defense. Georgia middling as far as offense is concerned, but remember, they did have Carter Ford out for about 5 or 6 games this season and had to play a tight end at quarterback, so their offense will be a bit more set in this game. Dangerous pass from C.J. Kirk there to get the first down as Reynolds able to haul that in a midst of traffic, and he's able to pick up the first down on an 11-yard catch. First and 10 now for C.J. Kirk. He rolls out, has the speed, throws back across his body. He's got Jay Keys there over the middle. 9-yard grab, the 70th catch on the season for Pitt's junior star receiver, Biletnikoff, a winner the prior season, and he is chasing the Pitt all-time receptions record. And there's an attempt to find him again over the middle. He was wide open, but Kirk just overthrows his star man, and it's going to be third and short now for the Panthers. Paul Leese goes in motion. Reynolds, the sidecar to Kirk. He's going to keep it himself, though, will the freshman quarterback, and he goes up the middle. 8-yard pickup, takes the contact, which Pat Narduzzi won't like, but he gets enough to get the first down. First and 10 now over the middle, trying to find Keys, and he is horse-collared to the ground. No call from the officials. Good defensive play by Georgia there. Third and long now for the Panthers. Kirk in the shotgun. Ogden goes in motion, has him over the middle, and that's the redshirt senior out of Texas, the former four-star receiver Benjamin Ogden. 13-yard pickup to move the chains and keep the drive alive for the Panthers. Keys now in at quarterback. He's going to give to Davion Reynolds on the jet sweep. Nowhere to go there. Loss of a yard for the Panthers' freshman phenom running back. Third and 11 now. Kirk back in the game in the shotgun here, trying to set up a screen. He's got Davion Reynolds out in the open field. Reynolds in space. He's up to the 10, to the 5, tries to beat a man. He's pushed out at about the 3. Great play call from the Panthers. They've used that screen very, very efficiently this season and turned in some big gains. They do just there, setting up first and goal, and C.J. Kirk is going to keep it himself. Great little misdirection there, running the option, and Kirk uses his speed and jets into the end zone as the Panthers draw first blood, going up 7-0 over the Georgia Bulldogs. Great drive there for the Panthers. Only one real third and long, and they converted with the pass to Ogden. So very impressive for their offense moving forward. And there's Travis Morris. We talked about him. Great return there for the senior receiver. Expected to be a very high pick in next season's NFL draft. You're going to have the handoff. That's going to be Tyler Stewart, also a senior. He's a very prolific running back, has missed a bit of time due to injury, but he's still a very, very good player and one that I think will be playing on Sundays next year. Blake Scott over the middle there. Carter Ford finds him for a 16-yard pickup to move the chains. Second and 10 now. Ford decides to keep himself on a read option. He does have the mobility. Takes a huge hit from Malachi Bordeaux. He is jet-powered forward, but it's a 6-yard pickup for the sophomore quarterback. Third and 4 now. Back to pass. Pitt rushes 4, so plenty of time. Tries to go underneath to Keith Williams, his tight end, who, of course, served as their emergency quarterback early in the season. He's unable to hang on, so it'll be a long field goal attempt for Georgia. That kick had the distance, but it's unable to find its way through the uprights, and the Panthers are going to be set up with great field position here at their own 40-yard line. They'll go to Davion Reynolds on first down. 2-yard pickup there for the freshman. Third and long now for Pitt. They go dual halfback look. We see C.J. London check into the game. Kirk's going to find Jay Keys there. Hauls that one in. Great gain there. 19-yard pickup for the junior, who, remember, needs 7 catches in this game to tie Tyler Boyd's Pitt career receptions record. 8 catches would give him the record, and that's 2 so far today. CJ London gets the handoff for a short gain, setting up 3rd and 5 now for the Panthers. Will they go 2 tight end look with Kirk under center? Back to pass, rolling out to his left, creates some time, trying to go for the end zone here, and he's lucky it's not intercepted. Tried to find Keys, but he underthrew that one. Remember, Kirk doesn't have the strongest arm in the world. Terry McIntyre comes across, deflects it away. The Panthers settle for a field goal attempt, and Johnny Midday pushes that one wide left, and so both teams trading missed field goals and resulting in good field position for the other. Carter Ford here, 2nd and 10, finds Travis Morris. That's going to take Georgia up to near midfield. 14-yard pickup for the senior and leading receiver on this Georgia Bulldogs team. 1st and 10 now. It's Tyler Stewart. He runs through a Darion Mitchell, shakes off a couple defenders. He's into the open field, nearly to the end zone. Jacob Lockham with a touchdown saving tackle. And look at Tyler Stewart run through arguably the Panthers' biggest hitter on their defense. A Darion Stewart, he shrugs him off and turns that into a huge gain. Handoff again to Stewart now on 1st down. Shakes off one man, and this time a Darion Mitchell. He's not going to get away from him this time. Big tackle there by the Panthers' junior outside linebacker. A Georgia native, in fact, from Tifton, Georgia, able to make the stop on the team from his home state. 3rd and 11. Now they go on a screen. That's A.J. Jackson Stroud, the true freshman. Short pickup before pushed out of bounds. It'll be 4th and long. Georgia settling for a field goal. This time it's up and through the uprights, and so it's a 7-3 Pitt advantage here late in the opening frame of football. Kirk's going to hand off to Davion Reynolds. He bounces off a couple of defenders, fights his way forward. 6-yard pickup, 2nd and 4 now for the Panthers. Reynolds stays in alongside Kirk in the shotgun. Play action, dumps it off to the senior tight end Antonio Greer, 4-year contributor for this Panthers offense, 4-year starter, and it'll be his last game in a Panthers uniform. 1st and 10 for Kirk. Motion. He's got a man trying to find Ogden. He's hit as he throws, and again, lucky to not get intercepted. Jay Gay, the man to deflect that one to the turf as he tried to pick it off. Disappointing from Kirk there, but he took a hit as he threw. Over the middle this time, he's got Jay Keys, was at the marker, fought through a tackle, and he's ended up just short of the line to gain as he tried to pick up that yardage. 3rd and 10 goes to 4th and 1, so the Panthers will have to punt it away as we come to the end of the first quarter. 7-3 Pitt. So Georgia now will start out with the football here. Carter Ford's going to go to Tyler Stewart. He's got plenty of room to the outside there. 9-yard pickup before the Panthers are able to bring him to the turf. 2nd and short as the Georgia rushing offense is looking solid, but hang on a minute. And Darion Mitchell steamrollers Stewart in the backfield there. Huge loss. It'll be 3rd and 5 for the Bulldogs. Ford back to pass. Panthers only rush 4. Plenty of time for him to throw. And he's got Scott Irons over the middle for a 7-yard pickup up to keep the drive alive. 1st and 10. Ford hands off to Stewart. He goes off tackle. Jacob Lachlan completely swings and misses on the big hit attempt, and Stewart is off to the races, and he's going to score. A huge run compounded by a gigantic mistake by the Panthers free safety. He's a guy that loves to come up, make a big hit, one of the leading tacklers on this Panthers defense. So it's not a mistake he makes often, but he just completely whiffs on the tackle. Stewart being very shifty, and he turns that into 6, and Georgia takes their first lead of the contest, going up 10-7. Panthers trying to get CJ London going here on 1st down. Nowhere to go there. He is brought down by Georgia's star linebacker Jason Baker. And it's going to be 2nd and 12 now for Pitt. Kirk's going to roll out, create some space for himself. Draws in the defense. He's got a man open. It's Jay Keys. He's off. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown. Kirk to Keys. 4-6. What a score for the Panthers. And this man, if he's going to go to the NFL, he is going to leave his mark on Pitt Panthers football lore. His longest touchdown of his career, his longest reception of his career, 77 yards for Jay Keys, and it comes in what may be his final game as a Pitt Panther. They let him get open behind the defense. We know he's not the fastest player in the world, so probably Georgia didn't think he'd be the guy to take the top off of the defense, but Keys goes through, fights through the bump and run coverage. Great little stutter step to put off the safety. And then he just releases behind him, gets wide open, and Kirk throws a strike, finds Jay Keys, and it's a touchdown for the Panthers, who retake the lead. But ensuing possession now for Georgia, 3rd and 10. It's Carter Ford, tries to find his tight end Williams. He's unable to do so, and the Panthers get a great defensive stop and will retake the football, looking to extend their advantage here. first and 10 now from just inside the 40. Davion Reynolds takes the handoff. Looked like he was going to cut up the middle. Decides to bounce it outside. 11-yard pickup there for the freshman. New set of downs for the Panthers. First and 10 now for Kirk at midfield. Back to pass. Pressure comes up the middle. He's got another man, and he's got another touchdown. Benjamin Ogden this time, and Big Ben strikes one. Touchdown for the Panthers. What a pitch and catch. CJ Kirk, we just mentioned how he doesn't have the strongest arm that we've ever seen here in Oakland, and yet he decides to uncork a couple of deep balls on consecutive throws. Benjamin Ogden, this time the recipient of a 53-yard score, and the Panthers have blown this one open. 21-10 they lead, and nearly they force a turnover there. Bordeaux got through the middle of the defense, knocked it away from Ford, but lucky for Georgia, they'll rule it an incomplete pass. But what a throw from Carter Ford on that last possession. Benjamin Ogden getting open. We talked about beginning of the season how much speed he has, and he finally was able to put that one to use. Gets behind the defense and uses that size and speed he has to make a big play. Nearly a big play for the Panthers defense there. Damian Vector goes up and knocks that one away following a Travis Morris big game. We talked about how important he is to this Georgia offense. They're going to throw this one outside to Quentin Williams this time. 4-yard pickup. 3rd and 6 now for Georgia. Ford in the shotgun. Panthers rush 4, settle back into zone coverage. They dump it off underneath. It's Keith Williams this time, and the Panthers converge on him. Quell Hampshire, the man to come forward and stop him short of the line to gain. So the Bulldogs will settle for a field goal that doinks its way in. Lucky to get that one to go through. And so the Panthers will take an 8-point lead here midway through the second quarter. Looking to extend that going towards the end of the half. They will be without Quell Hampshire. You notice their injury. He's going to try and fight through it, but he will be out for the time being. Second out for the Panthers. It's Benjamin Ogden motioning over the middle, and with that speed he has, he just breaks away from his defender, creates some separation, and it's a 15-yard pitch and catch for the first down for the Panthers. They go on the counter this time. Davion Reynolds tries to dance away from a couple of defenders, isn't able to sidestep around them, but he does have 10 yards and reaches the line to gain for the Panthers. 1st and 10, it's Kirk, keeps it himself on the read option there. Nice little 6-yard chunk that he's able to gain for the Panthers. 3rd and short now, and they go 5 wide set just inside the 45. Kirk back to pass, has a man open. That's Jay Keys for another big gain. That's going to move the sticks. 17-yard pickup for the Panthers inside the Georgia 25. Kirk back to pass on 1st down, quickly dumps it off. Nice little pirouette by Antonio Greer to haul that one in, thrown a little bit behind him, but it's a 4-yard gain, setting up 2nd and 6, where Pitt will hand off. It's CJ London. He goes on the counter, tries to break his way back inside, unable to shake the defender, but it's 7 yards when he needed 6, and it's a new set of downs for the Panthers. 1st and 10, we get our first Todd Sibley sighting of the day, the Panthers' other senior running back, able to get 4 yards there, sets up 2nd and 6 inside the 10 for Pitt. They go 3 wide set with Kirk in the shotgun. Plenty of time to throw. Tries to find Jay Keys on the fade, and it's well defended by Rhett right there. Keys went up for it. It was kind of a 50-50 ball, and great defense from the Georgia corner on that play. 3rd and 6 now. They bring the pressure over the middle. He tries to find Keys, and he's unable to hang on through the contact. That's a play you'd like Jay Keys to haul in. I don't know if he'd have had the first down regardless. And so Johnny McDay will come out for the chip shot, puts it through, and the Panthers restore their 11-point advantage with 2 minutes to play in the half. Tyler Stewart, though, off tackle. Plenty of room to roam forward. Avery Heller, the Panthers' junior strong safety, able to come up and make the tackle, but it's a 1st down gain for the Bulldogs. 3rd and 9 now. They got Travis Morris. Too much room on the coverage there. Way too much gap played by Damian Vector. Morris is able to get plenty of room on the comeback route. Ford finds him right exactly at the line to gain. Nick Newton over the middle for an 8-yard pickup. 2nd and short now for the Bulldogs. Ford looking to start airing it out a little bit as he dumps this one off to Tyler Stewart, and he is wrapped up by a Darion Mitchell, who's had his tractor beam set on Stewart ever since Stewart ran through him for that big gain in the first quarter. But this time Stewart gets away from the Pitt defense, picks up 9, and it's a good solid gain for the Bulldogs. Under a minute to play here. They used a timeout. It'd be first and 10 now. Carter Ford back to pass. Has a man open. That's his tight end, Keith Williams. He's out towards the sideline before Talik Bridges, the Panthers' sophomore outside linebacker, is able to haul him to the turf. Nice gain there for the Bulldogs. Ford back to pass. Looking to the end zone this time. Has Morris. And he can't get his foot down. He just clips the edge of the sideline. That could have been a huge play for the Bulldogs. Ford again trying to go to the end zone. A little bit of miscommunication with his receiver this time. Nowhere to throw it. And so he just chucks it out the back of the end zone. Third and 10 now. Ford back to pass. Pitt brings the pressure. Jalen Hills gets off the edge. Knocks the ball away. And again, Georgia lucky to not be called for a fumble. Instead, it's incomplete, which gives them the opportunity to bring the kicker out for their third field goal of the day. Slicing into the Panthers' advantage. And we go to halftime here at the Russell Athletic Bowl. Your Pitt Panthers 24, the Georgia Bulldogs 16. And so at halftime, as we take a look at the midway stats, Pitt airing it out, one of the most prolific games for CJ Kirk this season. 255 yards, no turnovers in the first half. Pitt's running game, not a lot to show for it, but they don't need to when they're racking up big plays like that. Georgia, on the other hand, very balanced offense. Carter Ford over 100 yards. They're rushing for over 100 yards as well. Tyler Stewart looking very good in the backfield. And so the Bulldogs will receive the football to get the second half started and try and even up this scoreline. It's going to be A.J. Jackson Stroud back to return from about a yard inside his own end zone. He takes a big hit from Jacob Laughlin. He doesn't swing and miss this time. And so Georgia's going to have a long field to go starting from their own 17-yard line. Ford, though, play action, dumps it off quickly. He's got his backup tight end. That's Jeff Hayward. 3-yard reception there. Sets up second and 7. Handoff this time as Tyler Stewart goes outside. Laughlin unable to bring down Stewart again. That's another missed tackle. The Panthers can't bring him down from behind. And Brian Youngling's going to have to come over and push him out of bounds lest he find his way to pay dirt yet again. That's a 40-yard pickup for Stewart and a huge gain for Georgia. This time A.J. Jackson Stroud comes in. He weaves his way through the Pitt defense. Nobody's going to touch him. And he's into the end zone on a 44-yard pickup. And so just like that, three plays and Georgia has found the end zone. What a run there. Incredible blocking. Hayward does a great job picking up the last ditch Panther defender. Jackson Stroud hits the hole and nobody's able to catch him from behind. So now the Bulldogs to go for two to try and even up the scoreline here. Ford has a man open, but Thomas unable to haul that one in right at the corner as he tried to stay in bounds. So Pitt retains a narrow 2-point advantage here as they start their opening drive of the second half. Nice little run by Todd Sibley there. 8-yard pickup. So it'll be 3rd and 2 for the Panthers. They go to Jay Keys now on the jet sweep. Nowhere to run for the junior wide receiver. Loss of 2. And so Georgia will come back on offense looking to retake the lead for the first time since early in the first quarter. And Tyler Stewart, 167 yards already on 11 carries. He's got a few yards there, but he's going to have a big gain attached to it because of the personal foul penalty on the Panthers for the face mask. So Georgia quickly into Pitt territory now. 2nd and 6. Ford finds Stewart this time on a screen. Lachlan's going to be the man to help bring him down, but it's an 11-yard gain for the senior tailback and a first down pickup. Jackson Stroud, he's going to be hit this time. Not going to be able to waltz untouched to the end zone. Ryan Jacobs brings him down for a loss of 4. 2nd and 14. Pitt brings delayed pressure. Ford does a great job getting the pass out quickly. And it's 3rd and 1 now after the nice pickup. Tight end goes in motion. Ford back to pass. Pitt again brings pressure, and this time it's going to get home, and it's Avery Heller, his 6th tackle of the day, gets the sack, and Georgia now with a 46-yard field goal attempt will take a 1-point lead, their 4th field goal of the day. Impressive day for their kicker. The only miss he had was from about 55 yards. He's been perfect otherwise, and so the Panthers fall behind by a single point. They go to Davion Reynolds here on 1st down, 8-yard pickup. But after a short loss, it's going to be 3rd and 5. Now for the Panthers, dangerous throw. Looked like Kirk was just locked in on Jay Keys from the start of that play. And Jason Baker read the Panthers quarterback's eyes all the way. Pitt lucky to not be intercepted there. 1st and 10. Ford tries to scramble away. And it's going to be a sack. Calvin Carlson, the senior middle linebacker. All of these Panthers defenders trying to do their best to make auditions for the NFL on both sides of the football. We saw Ogden, the senior, with the big touchdown. He's had a couple of nice grabs as well. Carlson now with the sack. Quell Hampshire trying to make his presence known from the middle linebacker position. Very impressive performance for the Panthers on an individual level. Carter Ford now dumps this one off. It's going to be Travis Morris and Jacob Lachlan. He's been so hit or miss literally today with his tackling. He does a great job bringing down Morris in the open field, forcing the punt from Georgia, and so the Panthers will get the football back. And this time, CJ London, a productive run, 10-yard pickup there, moves the chains for the Panthers. Kirk now bubble screen, has Jay Keys out wide, fights through. He's unable to fight through a block on the edge. It's a short pickup for Keys, but it's his sixth catch of the day, just one grab short of Tyler Boyd's all-time Panthers receiving record. This time it's going to be Ogden on the comeback. Nice grab there. He gets right to the line to gain and moves the chains for the Panthers. Second and 12 now. Kirk under center. Back to pass. Time in the pocket. He's got Jay Keys on the comeback route, and it's going to be a 20-yard catch that ties the all-time record for the Panthers. Great. 7 for 155 on the day today. So if this is going to be his swan song, it is a very impressive performance. Todd Sibley up the middle here. 6-yard gain for the redshirt senior, former 3-star prospect that's been with the Panthers all these years. Went to the national championship game, of course, with them last year in the loss to Alabama, and hoping to end his career with a victory. End of the third quarter, Georgia 25, Pitt 24. Second and 4 for the Panthers to get the fourth quarter underway, trailing by a point to the Georgia Bulldogs. Play action for CJ Kirk. He's going to roll to the outside. Plenty of room. Decides to dump it off, and it's intercepted. Centarius Scott jumps in front of it for the Bulldogs. I don't know what CJ Kirk was thinking. Every once in a while, he has one of these mental lapses that you just wonder, what in the world is he doing? He underhand pitches it. I mean, I think maybe he thought Scott was going to come try and tackle him as he scrambled. Instead, Scott stays at home, jumps in front of Paul Lease, and it's an interception for the Bulldogs. Great stand by their defense as they hold on to a narrow advantage. Third and one, it's Tyler Stewart. Lachlan meets him, but Stewart drives forward for a 5-yard pickup, moving the sticks and giving Georgia another first down. They go back to Stewart. He's clipped on the edge of the line there, and Avery Heller comes up and makes a great tackle. Loss of a yard there for Georgia. It's going to be 3rd and 7 now for their offense. Ford in the pistol, hands it off. It's Jackson Stroud, and Georgia basically concedes on that drive. The Panthers come steamrolling up the middle. Great tackle for Calvin Carlson, and Jay Keys, the junior star for the Panthers, comes back onto the field. 7 catches, needing one more to set the career record for the Panthers. So when you play in these bowl games, you want to end on a win, but there's so many personal achievements at stake. This is why Jay Keys said he's only focused on this game. So much he wants to still accomplish as a Panther. This would be a major accomplishment for him. 1st and 10 for Pitt. Kirk back to pass. Rolls out to his right. Tries to create some space. He's got the man! It's Jay Keys! And that's the record. 18 yards over the middle for Keys. His 8th catch of the day. His 255th of his career for the Panthers. Incredibly, in only 3 seasons. Actually, similar to what Tyler Boyd did. 254 in 3 seasons. And it's a new record for the Panthers. Take a bow, Mr. Jay Keys. What a player he's been. And a player that's been underregarded in this game and in this season. Paul Lease, the senior, playing in his final game for the Panthers. He hauls in his first catch of the day, 11-yard gain. But on first down, nowhere for Kirk to scramble away. Wheeler brings him down. Loss of 9, 2nd and 19 for the Panthers. Kirk going to roll out, try and create some space. He's got plenty of room to run. Instead, decides to throw it. He's got a man! It's Davion Reynolds! And that dude, Davion, finds pay dirt. A 46-yard throw. CJ Kirk again airing it out, taking the top off of the defense. He's been a big play merchant all game. He just has turned something into nothing on so many occasions. Another great throw. Why Georgia continues to allow these Panthers playmakers behind their defense is another matter altogether. But a huge touchdown freshman link up between Kirk and Reynolds. And Pitt's up 5. Now going for 2. Trying to make it a 7-point game. And that's Jay Keys. That one's not going to go on the score sheet. But it's a 3-yard, 2-point conversion for the Panthers junior star. And it's 32-25 Pitt now. Carter Ford finds his man. That's Scott Irons for a 9-yard pickup. Sets up 3rd and short for the Georgia offense, which has been sputtering here in the fourth quarter. But is trying to keep the game still in hand. Scott Irons, 10-yard pickup there. First down conversion for Georgia. Stewart now shakes off a couple of tacklers. Lachlan comes up and meets him behind the line. So a big tackle there. He's got 9, but he could probably have about 15 with all the missed tackles we've seen from Lachlan in this game. So a little bit of a juxtaposition in his performance there. Ford airs this one out. He's got a man. The pressure nearly got home. Instead, Ford stands in there and uncorks a bomb. He says, hey, CJ Kirk, anything you can do, I can do too. He finds Quentin Williams just as he was hit by Ryan Jacobs. The Panthers nearly get home with the pressure. Instead, Avery Heller, more renowned for his tackling than his pass coverage, unable to stay with Quentin Williams, and that's a touchdown for Georgia. All of a sudden, we're all square with just under 4 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. Reynolds there with a great run on the handoff there. First down pickup for Pitt up near their own 40-yard line. London checks in alongside Reynolds. Kirk's going to keep it himself. Nice little triple option here. Pitches it. He's got London in plenty of space. Almost had the edge and could have turned that into a huge gain. Instead, it's a 17-yard pickup for Pitt into Georgia territory as the clock continues to wind. Kirk keeps it himself. Read option. Fights his way forward. And that's a great second effort from the Panthers signal caller. 12-yard pickup into field goal range at this point as they look to now wind clock and take opportunities away from Georgia. Davion Reynolds, great work by him. Fancy footwork on the edge. Dances past a couple of defenders, and Davion's got a 21-yard pickup. Pitt quickly down to the Georgia 10-yard line now. They decide to go 5 wide this time. Kirk rolls away from pressure, but he's into the corner. Blitz, the ball's out, and Brian Carrington's recovered it. It was Santarius Scott again coming off the edge, creating havoc for this Georgia defense and taking the ball away from CJ Kirk. Kirk scrambled away from the pressure that came up the middle, but walked right into the waiting arms of Santarius Scott. The Panthers sideline can't believe it. And Georgia takes over now with an opportunity to win the game. They were just coming from behind, but Quell Hampshire has something to say about it still. Right up the middle, unblocked, and the senior former safety turned outside linebacker gets a huge sack. 2nd and 16. Pressure coming. It's knocked away. The Panthers almost turned over Carter Ford. That was Cedric Granger, the redshirt junior dime corner, coming off the edge there. 3rd and 16. Panthers needing a big stop. Ford is going to uncork it deep, and he's got a man. Scott Irons hauls it in. Scott Whaley was blanketing him in coverage, but the Panthers' sophomore corner gets his hands up. He's never able to fully locate the ball, and so it goes right through his outstretched arms, and it's a huge first down for Georgia, who can now run the clock down and set up a field goal if they really want to. 2nd down, it's Ford over the middle. He's got Williams short of the line to gain. The Panthers using their timeouts, hoping if they get a stop on Georgia here, they can get the football back. Heavy pressure from Pitt. Ford's got Quentin Williams yet again, and that's a first down for the Bulldogs. Pitt gets him out of bounds, so one timeout still. Georgia now just content to set up a field goal, it looks like. Tyler Stewart up the middle for a 4-yard gain. 2nd and 6, just over a minute to play. It's a handoff. Stewart and the Panthers look like they've made the executive decision. They're going to let Georgia score rather than allowing them to settle for a game-winning field goal attempt. Pitt wants to put the ball back in the hands of their offense. They let Stewart waltz into the end zone. He doesn't decide to go down short of the goal line. And so Georgia does take a 7-point lead, but the Panthers are going to get the football back with just over a minute to play. And if they can get some good field position here, we know what Reynolds can do in the return game. He's out across the 10. Great blocking on the edge for the Panthers. Reynolds unable to get past the defender there. If he doesn't get clipped by the defender getting back up, Reynolds could be off to pay dirt. Instead, still a 45-yard return. Pitt at least on the plus side of their own 40 to start this drive. Kirk's going to roll out on first down. He's got room as Georgia takes away the deep routes, and that's a 14-yard pickup by CJ Kirk. Pitt quickly into Georgia territory. 1st and 10 now. Kirk back to pass. Plenty of time. Looks underneath. Davion Reynolds there. That is a 7-yard pickup inside the Georgia 40-yard line. Pitt quickly hurries back to the line as they don't have any timeouts remaining. Kirk underneath. That's Paul Lease this time at about the 31-yard line. His second catch of the day for the Jersey Jet. The Panthers quickly back to the line where they spike it on first down, which will give them three downs to try and reach about the Georgia 20 to get the line to gain or score as they need a touchdown this possession. Second and 10 over the middle. It's Keys. Great coverage there by the Georgia defense on the edge, unable to let the football get all the way to the hands of the Panthers' top receiver, Jay Keys. Third and 10 now. Kirk nearly hit. Well, he is hit, but he's nearly sacked. They call it an incomplete pass. Lucky for the Panthers, as that could have killed all the time remaining on the clock. But fourth and 10, this is the ball game for the Panthers. Kirk back to pass. He's going to look for his main man, Jay Keys. But it's underthrown by Kirk. We know, we talked about earlier in the game, he's shown that the deep ball, he can throw it. But every once in a while, that arm strength leaves something to be desired. It's underthrown. Rhett Wright goes up. Could have had an interception. All he had to do, though, was knock it away. Jay Keys unable to get his hands on the football on his final collegiate down, potentially. And that's going to be it. Georgia kneels the football out. And it is a devastating loss for your Pitt Panthers, especially when they were up 32-25 in the fourth quarter. Devastating for this huge senior class, 19 seniors on this Pitt Panther roster, not to mention the likes of guys who may enter the NFL draft early. So a huge senior class for the Panthers that's unable to come away with the victory in their final game. But they put up a hard-fought effort. It just wasn't to be against a very talented Georgia team. So a great season still for the Panthers. 9-4, I'm sure many people will say it was a disappointment after last year. But for this Panthers team, young, so much roster turnover this particular year. A lot of guys stepping up into new roles. Still a very productive season for the Panthers and one that they can hopefully build on moving forward into next season. So as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. This will be our final game of this dynasty on this version of NCAA football. Remember, College Football Revamped will be coming to this file for Season 7. So we have plenty of more years of Pitt football. And it's going to be absolutely beautiful to watch. So as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Season 6, a rousing success. And I'm even more excited for us to move forward into Season 7 in this dynasty and see what the likes of CJ Kirk and Davion Reynolds can cook up for the Pittsburgh Panthers. So as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hail to Pitt. We'll see you very, very soon. Take care. Bye-bye.